Mr. District Attorney, starring David Bryan. Mr. District Attorney, champion of the people, defender of truth, guardian of our fundamental rights to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
And it shall be my duty as district attorney not only to prosecute to the limit of the law all persons accused of crimes perpetrated within this county, but to defend with equal vigor the rights and privileges of all its citizens. This is David Bryan. In a moment, we'll bring you another case from the files of Mr. District Attorney. But first, a word from our sponsor.
And now, here is our star, David Bryan, as Paul Garrett, Mr. District Attorney.
Crime has many byproducts that too often do not receive the attention they should. One such underrated byproduct of crime is its shattering effect on loved ones involved. Sometimes they suffer in silence. Sometimes they try to take matters into their own hands. One who took this unwise course was Ann Scott, who has come to the warehouse of the Walper Importing Company to speak to its owner in his private office.
Yes? Come in, come in.
Well, hello. Who are you?
I'm Ann Scott. You're Mr. Walper.
That's the name. What can I do for you?
Does a man named Claude Johnson work for you?
Yeah, for a long time. What about him?
That's what I thought you could tell me.
What? I'm afraid I don't get what you're driving at.
I want information, Mr. Walper. This man, Claude Johnson,
mm-hmm.
There's something wrong, and I want to protect my sister from it.
Your sister? Well, look, I don't like to be rude, but your family troubles, I don't see how they concern me.
Then what about these papers?
Bills of lading on my letterhead. Where'd you get them?
For my sister's desk.
Hmm?
They have something to do with what's going on between Barbara and Claude. And I'm going to find out, even if I have to go to the police.
The police? No. Now, wait a minute. Let's take it easy. You don't want to get your sister mixed up with the police, do you? Let me talk to Claude and see what I can find out.
All right. And thanks. Can I call you tomorrow?
That'll give me plenty of time.
Thanks again.
Miss Scott.
Yes?
Let's keep the police out of it. And don't say anything to anybody. Not until you hear from me.
I won't, unless I have to.
Lady, look out! Hey, stop! Stop! You hit her! You hit her!
Miss Miller, has Harrington called in yet?
Oh, Mr. Garrett. No, he hasn't called yet. Maybe that's Harrington now. District Attorney's Office. Oh, perfect timing, Harrington. He was just asking for you. Hold on. Do you want to take it here, Mr. Garrett?
Fine. Say, Harrington, anything new on that hit and run?
Pretty bad, Chief. Looks like a deliberate rundown. Almost went up the sidewalk to get her.
Did I understand it happened right outside the Walper Importing Company?
Yeah. In fact, the girl was just coming out of Walper's place when the car got her.
Run down that car, Harrington. I'll talk to you later.
Maybe I shouldn't say this, Mr. Garrett, but you look like a rabbit sniffing a juicy carrot.
Well, if Walper is mixed up in this somehow, I wouldn't exactly call him a carrot. I'm going over to General Hospital, and I want to talk to that Scott girl. See you later, Miss Miller.
Yes? Who are you?
The nurse said you could talk. I'm the district attorney.
Oh. I have nothing to say. Go away, please.
But, Miss Scott, it's our responsibility to catch the hit-and-run driver who struck you.
I won't tell you anything. Go away. Go away. Leave me alone. Go away.
Anne, dear, what's the matter?
You. Stop. Don't come near me.
Don't you know me? I'm your sister, Barbara.
Go away. Don't touch me. Oh, take her away.
Look, Barbara, Miss Scott, you better leave her alone.
I don't understand. What's happened to her?
I suggest we step outside and let her quiet down.
My own sister. Not wanting to see me.
Barbara, dear, why are you crying?
Oh, Claude, I'm so glad you're here.
Oh, what happened? Is Anne...
Oh, no, she'll be all right. But this gentleman and I were in the room. It was terrible.
Your sister's overwrought. That's all, Miss Scott. Oh, by the way, my name is Garrett, district attorney.
District attorney? Oh, I'm Claude Johnson, Barbara's fiancé.
Well, how do you do?
How do you do?
Miss Scott, I came here to ask your sister a couple of questions. Perhaps you might help me.
If I can.
First, about these bills of lading.
Where did you get those?
Well, they were in your sister's purse. Can you tell me why your sister went to the Walper Importing Company this morning?
Well, I just can't talk now.
Look, what is this, a third degree? Can't you see that Barbara's in no condition to answer your foolish questions?
When Barbara feels better, would you bring her to my office, please?
Of course. I certainly want to do what's right.
Fine. Goodbye.
Barbara, what was Anne doing with those manifests? How did she get them?
I don't know. But she's been so suspicious of us. She even warned me against you.
So that's it. Barbara, you're sure, my love, aren't you?
Of course, dear. I don't know what I'd do without you.
Sweetheart, there's only one answer. That shipment, the big one I told you about.
Oh, Claude, dear, do we have to talk about it now?
I got the advance word. I'm going to get my hands on every penny I can scrape together, no matter how.
Claude, I have money, and I want you to use it.
I told you, I won't touch your money.
Use my money and call it a loan. What's wrong with that?
Loan? Yeah, of course. But strictly as business. As soon as the deal's through, I could pay it back. And we could get married.
Of course, dear.
Well, that's it, then. Yeah, but we have to work fast. Now, how soon could you get the money?
I'll go to the bank this afternoon.
Oh, Barbara, you're wonderful. Yeah, I better get back to work. Call you later,
Of course, darling.
Oh, you going back in to see Anne?
No, I can't. I'll talk to her nurse.
Yes, let her rest. She needs lots of rest. Goodbye.
Okay, that'll do it. You're loaded. Now hightail it down to the dock.
Walper talking. Look, Skipper, I told you a dozen times. Don't worry, we'll get the mermaid loaded in good time. I'm taking care of everything. Okay.
Hello, Walper.
Well, if it isn't the district attorney himself, what's the occasion for this visit?
A few questions. What do you know about a girl named Anne Scott?
Anne Scott? It's a pretty name.
Why did she come here this morning?
Maybe to get out of the sun. How should I know? What's it all supposed to be about?
I don't know yet. But I certainly intend to find out why someone tried to kill that girl with an automobile. Well,
sure. You're playing the wrong horse asking me questions.
Hey, Chief, is everything all right?
Harrington, what brings you?
Miss Miller told me you'd be here. Figured you'd like to know. We found the hit-run car.
Good work.
Same broken headlight. And you know what, Chief? The car's registered to Barbara Scott.
And sister?
Mm-hmm.
Where's the car now?
10th Street Garage. I'm going to check back with the attendant who was on duty when it was brought in.
Well, get right on it. Call me with anything new.
Right, Chief. Where'd you be?
Having a talk with Barbara Scott. This time she'll answer questions, shock or no shock.
Okay.
See you later.
Well, dear, I guess you won't need me anymore. Got some work to do.
All right, Walper. But I might turn up with a few more questions for you later.
If you say so. I'm afraid it's the wrong horse again, D.A., but keep punching.
I will, Walper. I will.
Walper.
Hmm?
Walper, is he gone?
Claude. What's the idea, hiding behind those cases?
Look, I'm in a jam. I need some help.
Sounds like it. What's this all about? First the girl and now the D.A. You behind all this?
Well, in a way, I guess so.
You guess?
Why are you stupid, Cormac? Stop it. Let me go.
Say, but I ought to kill you. The D.A. would give his right arm to sock it to me, and you got him nosing around.
Don't worry. You give me a little cooperation, everything will be okay.
Cut the double talk. Let's have it. What's the story?
Well, I saw a chance for some easy money. Barbara thinks a lot of me. Thinks I'm going to marry her. So I figured out a deal.
Using my manner.
Just window trimming. I told her I had an inside track in the market. Then I cinched it by borrowing a couple $100 from her a couple of times, gave it back with profit. As soon as I get the money from Barbara this afternoon, I clear her out of the country.
Just like that.
Huh? Well, why not? Your ship, the Mermaid, is loading up and starts for the Far East tonight, doesn't it?
Huh?
Well, you give the okay, I'll be on that ship and nobody will find me.
Do I get help?
Okay. Why not? You deserve a break. You'll ship on the Mermaid.
I thought you'd see it my way. Now, fix it with the skipper, huh?
Sure, he's expecting my call anyway. No, this is Walper. Let me talk to Skipper. Hey, Skipper. Claude Johnson's on his way down. He wants to talk to you about going with your ship tonight. Yeah, it's all okay. Take care of him. So long.
Thanks, Walper. Thanks a lot. I'll be back when things quiet down.
Glad to do it. Get down there and check with Skipper. And you might as well take down whatever you need now.
Good deal. Thanks again.
You're welcome. You're real welcome. Skipper? Walper again. What I said about Johnson goes double. Take care of him. Take care of him real good.
Get that cargo swing over here! Easy! Hold it!
Hey, up there on the Mermaid! Tell Skipper Claude Johnson's here. Johnson! Watch it, that cargo sling! Coming right at me! Go!
This is David Bryan. Before we continue with Mr. District Attorney in the case of the hit-and-run killer, here is an important message I'd like you to hear.
And now back to David Bryan, starring as Paul Garrett, Mr. District Attorney.
The girl had almost been murdered by a car belonging to her sister. But with all the tangled threads I held, I could see none that pointed to a motive. Anne Scott, terrified by her narrow escape from death, refused to tell me anything. Her sister Barbara had to know some answers, including the mysterious shipment manifest from Walper's company. And the answer to the big question, why would Barbara want to kill her sister? I'll get it, Miss Miller. Hello?
Hello, Chief.
Harrington, have you found her yet?
No, not a sign. Pretty strange. She didn't show up for an appointment with a hairdresser. Now, when a dame does that, something's wrong.
And keep digging, Harrington. We've got to locate Barbara Scott.
You know me, Chief.
You think she ran out, Mr. Garrett?
It doesn't gel, Miss Miller. Still, the way that fiancé of hers, Claude Johnson, tried to prevent me from asking her questions, maybe he fits in somewhere.
Did you say Claude Johnson?
Yes. You know him?
Just a minute. That name rings a bell. Of course, here it is. Look at this, Mr. Garrett.
Well, this is the old Walper file.
Remember you told me to get it together? Well, I did, and look.
The name on the payroll.
Oh, Claude Johnson. So he worked for Walper.
He did a year ago. What does it mean?
It means you're a very remarkable young woman, Miss Miller. And now we're looking for two of them, Barbara and her fiancé. Let's go.
You did say we're looking, didn't you?
Oh, I did. And so we are, right now.
Anne, it's me, Barbara. Oh, wake up, Anne, please. What? Barbara, go away. Go away, don't kill me.
What are you saying, Anne?
I'll go away. I won't try to interfere. You can marry Claude. Don't kill me.
Stop it. Stop it, dear.
I'm sorry I shook you, but I can't understand you talking this way. Anne. But I saw the car before it hit me. It was your car. I know it was your car.
My car? You must be delirious.
I saw the car plain. I knew you were angry that you hated me for warning you against Claude, for trying to find out about him, but I was only trying to protect you.
Oh, Anne.
Tell me, before my car hit you, did you see me driving it? I couldn't see. There was a reflection on the window. Barbara, where are you going?
There's something I have to do. You just rest, Dad, and get well.
You're Mr. Walper, aren't you?
I am. We're closed for business.
Your watchman told me you were back here. I'm Barbara Stott.
Yes? I'm in sort of a hurry.
I want to find Claude Johnson.
He's probably at his apartment.
I tried, Joe. He hasn't been home since this afternoon.
I see.
It's very important that I talk to him.
Well, matter of fact, I haven't seen him all afternoon.
But you must have. He phoned me, said you were sending him down to the waterfront on a job, and he'd call me as soon as he got back.
It did.
Something's wrong here. Good night, Mr. Walters.
Hold it. Where do you think you're going?
I came here to find Claude and give him one more chance to explain. But now I think I'd better go directly to the district attorney.
Think again, Miss Scott.
A gun.
That's right. And it says you'll step over to my car without any trouble. Come on.
I don't understand.
Just move it. You're going for a boat ride. A very short boat ride.
He's going to be surprised to see us.
I could have called, but I figure I might take a look around Miss Scott's apartment myself.
You think Harrington might be asleep?
It's very possible. He's been staked out here waiting for Barbara for the last 2 hours.
Soft job. Well, this is it. Number 213.
Right.
Oh, gee, Miss Miller.
Barbara didn't come home? No telephone calls.
Yeah, nothing at all. But real quiet here.
Well, you see that, Harrington? Your socks are showing.
Huh? Oh, yeah. I took off my shoes. You know, sort of rest my feet.
Bless her in your own time. You're from downtown?
Oh, gosh. I almost forgot. Hey, that garage attendant called back. Full description on the person who brought the hit-run car into repairs. Interesting.
Oh, Harrington, don't be so mysterious.
It was a him. Perfect description of that Claude Johnson fellow.
Claude? He brought the car in alone?
Yep, all by himself.
He must have been driving Barbara's car. I just knew she couldn't be trying to kill her sister.
Perhaps. Anne was on to something and had to be stopped.
Her sister could still be in the middle of it.
Very much so. But if she isn't, she might be in a very dangerous spot. We've got to find Claude before there's another accident and winds up in murder.
But where do we find her?
I think Walper might know the answer to that one. Let's go, Harrington.
I'm with you, Chief.
I'm sorry to bring this up, Harrington, but don't you think you might need to see?
Oh, you women, think of everything. Go ahead, Chief. I'll catch up with you.
This is the dock.
Those lights out on the water. That must be Walper's ship, the mermaid.
It is.
There's Walper, coming out of the cabin in that motorboat at the dock.
Now Walper and that other fellow are loading wooden cases into that dory.
Is that what you call that little boat, a dory?
That's right, Miss Miller. And I see it's made fast to his boat with a line. Walper is evidently going to tow the dory out to the big ship, the mermaid.
Hey, Keith. They're through putting the cases in the dory. The other fellow's going. Walper's alone.
Good. I'll go talk to him. You stay here in the car, Harrington, just in case Claude is around.
Right.
Coming, Miss Miller?
Nothing I like better than a walk along the waterfront at night.
Hello there, Mr. Walper.
What? Oh. Oh, Jack. Be with you as soon as I put this crate down on the deck. Yeah.
Your watchman said we'd find you here. Mind telling me where you're going?
Why should I mind? I'm in the importing business, remember?
I remember.
So, I also export. My ship's sailing in an hour, and I'm taking out some cases of supplies to it.
I see. These cases?
Yeah. Canned stuff and some ship supplies. Want me to open one up for you?
Well, that won't be necessary. I've checked customs. They've already cleared your ship for sailing.
Don't miss a trick, do you? I'll open a case anyway. See? Canned goods, that's all.
Fair enough. And the cases in the dory are the same?
Sure. Put them in there because I'm taking the dory out. The mermaid needs another lifeboat.
Okay. Where's Claude Johnson?
Claude? Haven't seen him all afternoon.
Isn't that unusual?
What's unusual about it?
Well, on a day one of your ships is loading, I think all of your employees would be busy.
Oh, you got it wrong, miss. Johnson's my bookkeeper. He doesn't work the dock.
How about Barbara Scott? Any idea where she is?
I don't even know her. Now, look, D.A., this stuff you're asking. What's it all got to do with me?
I have every reason to believe your man Johnson was involved in a hit and run, and I'd like your help in finding him.
I'd be glad to help if I could. Tomorrow I'll have more time.
I see. Just stay here, Miss Miller. I'll be right back.
Hey, where are you going?
I'll look into your cabin.
Hold it. You got no search warrant.
And I'm not making a search, Walper. You can't keep me out of there.
I think I can. With this.
Mr. Garrett, he's got a gun.
You take one more step towards the cabin, the little lady here gets it first. Now back.
Thanks, Hankin. You just dazed me with the gun, but.
Sorry, I was a little slow. But Walper won't be butting anybody else for a while.
Yeah, I see that. Where's Miss Miller?
Down here in the cabin. Barbara Scott's here.
We're coming.
You had her tied up?
Yeah, gag, too. Let me take this tape off her mouth. Yeah.
Oh, it's better. I can hardly breathe. You were so frightened. You told me he had to kill Claude and that I was next. He was going to throw my body out to sea.
There, dear, now don't think about it.
And you're so right about Claude. He tried to warn me. That's why he tried to kill her with my car.
That's the way it figures, all right. But, Chief, I don't get Walper's part in all this. Was he in on the con game?
No, Harrington. Walper was in on a much bigger game. The answer is in those cases in the dory.
The wooden cases?
Yes. Can you walk all right, Miss Gunn?
Yes, I'll be fine now.
Give her a hand, Harrington. Let's go.
Good.
Be careful stepping on the dock here.
But, Chief, what do you mean those cases in the dory of the answer?
Come on, I'll show you. Oh, bring that crowbar, Harrington.
Hey, this dory is full of cases of supplies.
I don't think they're all supplies. I'll open this one. Now we'll just push aside some of this sawdust. There.
Wow. Look at that.
Mr. Garrett, that looks like a bar of gold, solid gold.
Exactly what it is, Miss Miller. And this little boat is loaded with those golden bars. Mr. Walper was taking them to Singapore.
But why?
For a tremendous and illegal profit. You see, gold here in the United States is pegged at $35 an ounce. But in Singapore, on the black market, Walper could sell it easily at $80 an ounce.
Yeah, a nice bit of exporting, all right. Well, what do we do now, Chief?
You stay here until we can get the harbor authorities to round up the rest of the crew. In the meantime, I think Miss Scott would like to see her sister.
Oh, I would, Mr. Garrett, more than anything in the world.
This is David Bryan. I hope you enjoy this case from the files of Mr. District Attorney. I'll be back in just a moment after this message from our sponsor.
Now, here's the star of Mr. District Attorney, David Bryan, with a word about the program you have just heard.
It was not very long after that you've probably read in your newspapers about the conviction of the man we called Walper on the charge of first-degree murder, along with his henchman Skipper. You may have also read of the rounding up the various members of the vicious gold-smuggling gang and the federal punishments meted out to them. Now, this is David Bryan inviting you to join us when we present our next case based on the facts of crime from the file of Mr. District Attorney.
Mr. District Attorney was originated by Philip H. Lawrence.